Russia and North Korea's increasingly close relationship is under fresh scrutiny tonight, with US intelligence revealing that arms negotiations between the two countries are actively advancing. Moscow appears desperate to obtain extra munitions as Ukraine tries to fight off more deadly strikes. More now from our Europe correspondent, John Paul Gonzo.
Another country-wide attack, and again the capital bore the brunt. Russian drones and missiles pummeled Kyiv, killing two people in what officials call the most powerful strikes to hit the city since spring. Everyone is tired of the war, this woman says, but it doesn't mean we will give up anything to anyone. Ukraine's slow and costly counteroffensive is seeing small gains, with military bosses buoyed by the liberation of a strategically important village near Zaporizhia. They say it paves the way for Kyiv's forces to push further south towards Melitopol and even Crimea, which Russia seized in 2014. And there are further signs Moscow's grip on the war is slipping, with the US revealing President Putin and North Korean leader Kim Jong-un have been trading letters as Russia seeks to replenish dwindling stocks. The White House now claims a potential weapons deal between the two countries is advancing.
We cannot and we will not stay silent as we receive more information that Russia continues to turn to rogue regimes to try to obtain weapons and equipment in order to support its brutal war of aggression.
One pariah state relying on another. The White House calls it weakness and desperation, and more evidence Vladimir Putin's war is faltering. John Paul Gonzo for 10 News First.